In this lesson, I'm going to write a PLC program that can start and control the heavy three-phase electrical motor with the start-delta starter method. To assist in learning this concept in more depth, I'll write the program in two different ways, and then test each of the programs online with the PLC simulator to see if they work as needed. So let's get started. To get started with programming, I click the Somatic icon on the desktop. In software environment, the first thing I need to do is create a new project. To do this, from the File menu, I select New. In the New Project window, I'll give my project a name and then click OK to create the new project. In the next step, I need to define what type of S7 PLC I'm going to use for this project. To do this, I first click on my project, and then from the Insert menu, I select Station. There's a list of all the stations that I can choose from for my project. Now, which one should I choose? The CPU that I have in the actual environment is a 315-2DP. The 300 here shows that my PLC is an S7-300 PLC, so here I should choose Somatic 300 Station. If I open the project tree, you can see that an S7-300 PLC has been added. I've defined the type of PLC that I'm going to use in this project, but what about the other PLC modules? The next step is to define the PLC modules within the software that I have in the actual environment. To do this, I select Station here, and then double-click on Hardware in the right side window. My PLC is an S7-300, so I have to choose my modules from the Somatic 300 subfolder here. The first thing that I did in the actual environment was to install a rack that will hold my PLC modules. This is the same for the software. To define the PLC modules, I need to have a rack in the software. To add a rack, I'm going to open the Rack 300 folder and then double-click Rail. Now I have a rack that contains 11 slots. The first module that I placed on the rack in the actual environment was a 2-ampere power supply that powers the CPU and the I/O modules. To place the same module on the rack in software, I open the PS300 folder and double-click on this 2-ampere power supply. I have to place the CPU on the second slot, so to do this, I open the CPU300 folder. There's a list of all S7 CPUs that I can use. My CPU is a 315-2DP, so I should open this folder here. As you see, there are different order numbers for this CPU listed. Which one should I use? To determine which one to select, I have to see what the exact order number of my CPU is, and then choose the same CPU here and put it on the rack. Let's assume that the order number of my CPU is 315-2AF02-OABO, so I need to choose this CPU here and place it on the rack. Since my CPU has a DP port, as soon as I place it on the rack, this window opens up to help me create a Profibus network. I don't need this type of network for this project, so I click Cancel. Because this CPU has a DP port, an extra X2 row has been added to my rack here. In the lower window, you have access to more information about the modules you have installed on the rack. In the next lesson, I'm going to add the input and output modules to the rack and then download the hardware to the PLC. If you found value in this video, show your love and like this video. That does two things. First, that gives us the motivation to keep making free valuable content for you. And second, it helps other people just like you to find our videos more easily through YouTube. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel if you haven't already done so. That way, each new video will be sent to you as it's published. How would you like to get access to a library filled with top-notch PLC programming lessons, as well as new video lessons delivered to you every week? For more info and free training, go to realpars.com.